I will show you guys how to record your computer screen even if you're just a beginner.
Bob doesn't know how to use OBS Studio properly and makes excuses on why he can't learn.
Don't be like Bob. I want you to get something out of this video, so let's get it started.
Make sure you have OBS Studio downloaded, then install OBS Studio. Run OBS Studio, then you will see the OBS user interface with an auto configuration wizard. If this doesn't show up, then go to Tools and click on the auto configuration tool here. Select the optimize only for recording option, click next. Canvas resolution is basically the resolution of the selected monitor. For most people, current is fine. I recommend setting the frame rate to 60 unless you plan to record 30 FPS footage. Click next. OBS has determined these settings for us, then click on apply settings. Select settings, go to output. So in the output mode, you can choose between advanced and simple. Just keep things simple. So for the audio bitrate, enter 320. The recording path is the location of your recording. You can browse and choose where you want your recordings to be saved. You can choose between high quality, indistinguishable, and lossless recording quality. So for most people, I would recommend high quality. However, if you have a lot of storage space on your hard drive and want to squeeze out a bit more quality, choose indistinguishable.
2,000 years later.
For the recording format, choose MKV instead of MP4 because the final result will be MP4 anyway. So for the encoder, you will have different options like X264, which is for your CPU, and NVENC, that is for your NVIDIA GPU. Each graphics card has its own encoder, so you may have a different encoder name if you have AMD or an Intel GPU. If your computer has no hardware encoder option, choose X264. If your computer has hardware encoder options such as NVENC, then please use it. So let's keep things simple and pick NVENC's H264. Go to audio, keep the sample rate at 48 kHz. For the desktop audio, set it to the device where your sound is coming from. I will select my headset. For the mic, select the mic you're going to use. Choose video, keep the canvas resolution at default because it is the resolution of your display. So for the scale resolution, keep it at the same resolution as canvas. If you do decide to downscale your recording, make sure to set the downscale filter as bicubic. As previously stated, keep the FPS at 60 FPS unless you intend to record footage at a lower frame rate. Go to hotkey, you can configure keyboard shortcuts for actions over here, such as start recording and stop recording. I will let you play around with this. Choose advanced. Set process priority to above normal or high, as OBS requires processing power to record properly. For the majority, Rec 709 is the most logical choice. However, if you're using a low-end computer that uses your CPU to record, use sRGB as it places less strain on your computer. Rec 2100 is used for HDR. Select automatically Remux to MP4, which will automatically convert your MKV recordings to MP4. Press OK. Click on plus button on sources, then add display capture, then press OK. As you can see, our display is visible in preview. You can go on display and choose the other monitors that you want to record. So we added display capture for OBS, which allows you to record your computer screen. Now right click where it says scene and then rename. I will name it desktop capture, as it is something I would use if I wanted to capture my desktop. Click on the plus button on scenes. It will then ask you to enter a name. Since we're gonna be recording gameplay, we will name it gameplay capture. Press OK. Click on the plus button on sources, then add game capture. Then press the OK button. As you can see, it is selected to record only full screen game. However, we are going to change that so it can actually record a game directly. We have a section called window where you can select the game you want to record. Make sure your game is turned on so that OBS can detect it when you're on game capture. So we are now going to choose our game. As you can see, our game is now available for preview. Now press OK. Sometimes your game may not scale fully to your entire screen, so a simple fix would be either to increase the game's resolution so it matches the monitor's resolution, or manually scale the game capture with OBS like this. So in OBS, we have an audio mixer with sliders. Moving your slider to the left will lower the volume. A good practice is to have your desktop and game audio be lower than your mic so that people can understand what you're saying. Play around with the sliders until you find the right balance. Select the desktop capture scene. Click on Start Recording. I will do a test recording just as a demonstration. If you want to stop recording, click on Stop Recording. As you can see, it will automatically remux your MKV recording, so we'll choose our gameplay capture scene. Check that your game appears in the preview window. Click on Start Recording to begin recording the game. Then just play the game as you normally do. When you are finished, you can press the Stop Recording button. Click on File and select Show Recording. This is a good way to find out where your OBS recordings are stored. Make sure to view in the detailed mode so you can determine which video is MKV and which one is MP4. MP4 is the format you want to focus on. Ignore MKV, you can delete it if you want to. So you can now play back these recordings and do whatever you want with them.
Well done on getting this far, just keep at it and you'll be a legend, alright? Anyways, check out my other videos and Yogamo guys, and have a Yogamalicious day.